purpose has not been realized because you've had the wrong attitude. Jesus was attracted to you because he saw his purpose that he put in your life.
Soul and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Yes, this is a great day. It's the day that the Lord has made, and I have commended myself. That's me, my mind, my body, my spirit, to give praise to the Lord. Apologize for the little delay here of coming on, but you know, when you do it live at TV, you know, sometimes you got to adjust and readjust. So I'm just satisfied to have this opportunity to share with you on this glorious day. Yes, this day as we move forward into the resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Savior, as we commemorate and celebrate one of the greatest, if not the greatest, event in the life of Christianity everywhere. So we're so thankful. This is Pastor Robert Gardner with The Truth Will Make You Free. And again, we're live here in the studios of WHBR TV 33. And those of you that are getting us on these various networks that we have coming through you, coming to you on, we certainly want you to let us know and whether or not this telecast is a benefit to you. I believe it is, because anytime we hear the word of God and God is speaking to you collectively, you individually, I believe that it is necessary. Praise God. In today's economy, it is necessary. But all of the various things that are going on in the world today, I think it is necessary to hear words from God. And what I'm learning day by day, amen, as I continue to do the work of the ministry, I'm finding as I minister to various people across this country and other places, then I find that God's spoken word is God's activity. When that word is spoken, God is already in action. I know we like to say many times, God will do, God is going to do, but that word, when it is spoken, that word already has in it the necessary power, the necessary authority and ingredients to do what is proclaimed. I believe that waiting has to do our own adjustments. It doesn't have to adjust. The word doesn't have to be adjusted to work. The word doesn't have to have a delay capsule in order for it to work. What happens is, many times, our mind and our body, our spirit has to resonate with what has been spoken. It's hard to, many times, to when you're going through and you're having various challenges in your life, to see God's word as now. Praise God. Amen. Next doesn't mean now, but now means next. Amen. Which means that it is already there. Now is now. Next is maybe in the future, somewhere down the road. But I believe that we serve a right now God. So that word of God, when it's spoken into our spirit, as we receive it, it works. Amen. It begins to work. It's like taking a capsule or some medication that you have gotten from your physician. And when you take that medication, it goes to work then. It just got to work its way through the biological system in order to, before you feel the effect. So the body, amen, can connect with what you just put in it. So my sisters and brothers, what I'm saying is that the word of God is our source. The Word of God is our strength. The Word of God is our comfort. Amen. And as we look into this event of Good Friday, and which is the death and the burial of our Savior, and then as we look beyond Good Friday into Resurrection Sunday morning, we see a miracle, and in that one miracle, we are exposed to many miracles. It's not just one miracle. Jesus, first of all, they rolled the stone away, and then he got up. That's miraculous. However, in that one miracle, we receive many miracles. We receive every promise, every word that has been spoken is now fulfilled. And yes, you can have just what you want. Praise God. Amen. I want to give you a takeaway, as I do per usual. I want you to get your Bible and turn to Mark, the 16th chapter. And I want you to read verses 1 through 14 a day about. Amen. But I just want to see if I can just focus on the first four verses there. Amen. When we see where the stone is rolled away, and I want to talk to you. Amen. Just that point. God will move the stone. God will move the stone. Your frustration is needless. Your fear is needless. Many people are walking around in needless fear right now, because of the possibility of things that they have to do, and they think that it's been blocked. But when you get there, you're going to see a different effect. So this is what happened in this series, and we're going to talk about that in a little bit more detail this morning. But I want you to just connect with a friend or a neighbor and tell them that Pastor Gardner is live. And you can connect with me, and I guarantee you. Now, the number there on the screen is for prayer. As for the offline prayer, you can call 586-754-9673. Amen. And yes, we are in our Holy Week here at the Word of Truth of praying and fasting. Amen. We are studying the Word of God. Today is prayer time, per usual, at 11 a.m. here at the Word of Truth at 7107 Rivard Avenue in Warren, Michigan. You can connect with us. You can come by the church. You can pray. Or you can just give me a call and say, Pastor, I can't make it, but I have some things that are going off in stones, amen, that I need rolled away. Praise God. And I'll make intercession with you in the now, because I know what has already taken place. And I'll just assist you, amen, in comforting you with the Word of God, letting you know that you can move forward. So, my sisters and brothers, give us a call at 586-754-9673. And let's make intercession together. For the Bible said, when we know not what to pray for, the Holy Spirit, and sometimes you can get that way. Amen. I've gotten that way a couple times, when sometimes things can come in at you so quick and so thrustful that you say, oh my God, what am I going to do? Then, at that very moment, you have to know that you're standing in the presence and power of God. It's right there where you are. And if you can create that type of consciousness, amen, the enemy will never be able to break you. I am right now standing in the presence and the power of Almighty God. And whatever's going on, you're getting ready to get your breakthrough. Sometimes you don't have to say anything. Amen. You don't have to make up words. You don't have to stumble, because when you're trying to stumble and praying, you start drifting. Amen. You get mad in your own prayer. You're praying for someone that did you wrong, and you know you can't do that right there. Just stand in the presence and the power of Almighty God, and He will help you to forgive. He will give you the strength to go on. He will give you the strength to put that behind you. So the Holy Spirit, when we do not know what to pray for, the Holy Spirit will make intercession for us, getting, searching the Spirit, searching your life, searching all things. He knows all things, and he'll take it right to the Father, and the Father will give you your answer. So my sisters and brothers, I want you to be prepared this morning. Amen. And if you're getting this telecast on replay, then I want you, whatever time it is, I want you to know that this word is exactly for you. God will move the stone. Unnecessary anxiety, unnecessary fears, unnecessary thoughts and thinking, amen, on stuff that you don't believe that you can do. Amen. So I want us to get this morning, and I want you to connect with the season. I believe that this is the time of the year that whatever is going on in your life, you can walk out of it. Amen. Because Jesus took everything that will ever concern you. He took it to the cross. Amen. And it went down. It took it down when he went down, it went down. When he got up, he had destroyed it. Amen. And we too can walk in the newness of life. So every bondage, every thing that is holding you backwards, the stone has already been rolled away. So my sisters and brothers, again, this is Pastor Robert Gardner, and I'm live here in the studio at WHBR TV 33, and I'm excited about God. I was away last week as well as Minister Archer. Amen. And we apologize for that, but it just couldn't be helped. Usually we try to coordinate our schedule, but things just collided. So we're just excited, but we're back here on this morning, this Tuesday morning together. And I'm excited, and God bless you, Minister Archer. How are you? And welcome. I'm glad to see you.
I know. I'm glad to see you. I miss being here. And I said, oh, my goodness, I'm just missed it. I miss you. I miss being here. I missed our wonderful audience. I did.
Amen. And I'm thinking I had to go to Memphis, Tennessee. And while they're in Memphis, and I got up that morning getting ready to go to my session, and I said, oh, my God, what is the world doing now? Mm-hmm. We are not
on the air.
We are not live. How people really believe, you know. Then I thought, I said, well, they have received enough
word.
They heard enough to keep them going until next Tuesday. Amen. So your testimony is there.
It's so there. It's so exciting. And I'm just so excited. And oh, my gosh.
Yes.
We'll roll away the stone.
Yes.
Yes. I'm so excited. And listen, we got a little update.
Yes.
We are on Facebook Live.
Wow.
So if
wow.
You know, Facebook can find us.
Can find us.
Yes.
You got to help me with that. How do they find us?
Okay. So I believe in the engineer will correct me if I'm correct.
Yeah.
But all they have to do is go on their Facebook page, and they can pull up the Facebook page of the station, which right now is listed under RJ Watkins.
Okay.
So if they put in their search engine, RJ Watkins, they're going to be able to see us live.
Oh, wow.
So they need to tell everybody they can see us live on Facebook.
And then they got a whole lot of connections going on here.
Yes.
I would, the other Roku.
Yeah, so they got the Roku, and this is a whole different, so we'll know for sure, but definitely you can pull up on Roku and a lot of the other electronic avenues to actually watch the show. If you make it, you can call in, and you'll call there, you'll see the phone number to give the call, 313-868-4336, and you can always, also on Facebook, you can make comments and whatever, so if they make a comment, oh, good morning, I'm watching, good, how are you, or I have a question or whatever, actually, it'll come up on the screen. And I have it actually on my phone.
Yeah, all right.
So I can look on the phone. Yeah. Oh, we have a wonderful screen. So if they make comments or if they have a question or whatever, they can just type it in and we'll get it.
So if you see us looking to our
That's
right,
why.
It's simply because we're monitoring, you know, your comments and seeing what you wonderful things that you have to say.
So you'll
be able to look on your screen right there. But you know, that's technology.
It is. It is. I'm excited about it.
It's how that you can be all over the planet.
Amen. Oh my goodness, hold on, see, now, and bear with us, because this is our first time doing it this way, and so I'm already excited because somebody, I shared it on my page, and a beloved woman of God, I love her so much, she just put a comment that she is watching.
Praise God.
I'm so excited. Amen. Thank you so much.
Thank you, amen. Thank you for watching, and we appreciate that, because we don't want to just be beating the air.
That's right.
And I know that many times there are those who are watching get caught up. I know many times when I'm not here and I'm watching you and your guests that you have on with you, I get so caught up that, you know, I can't call. I don't want to miss nothing. I just can't miss the flow. But yes, that's he will.
He will.
Amen. God will move.
Stone. It doesn't matter what that stone is.
Hello.
God will move it.
Amen.
Just like you were saying, we're getting ready for. And I love how you tell us and teach us anyway.
Uh-huh.
All these seasons, quote unquote, they're all connected.
Connected.
Amen. We can't separate Christmas from Resurrection, from Good Friday, whatever. It's all connected.
Amen.
God. Amen.
I'm studying my message for Sunday morning.
Yes.
And as I was meditating, the ultimate Christmas gift.
Wow.
The ultimate Christmas gift.
Praise God.
I mean, you know, we talk about the birth of Jesus.
Yes.
But the ultimate gift culminates on the cross of Calvary and the resurrection.
Wow, that's good. That's
amen.
Good.
Follow the gift.
That's
Christmas gave us Jesus.
Yes.
And the ultimate gift that comes from that is that God sent him in the world to die.
Amen.
Amen. For our sins and our healing and our resurrection.
Yes.
So that ultimate gift of Christmas filters all the way through Good Friday, the death, the burial, and on Sunday morning. That's the ultimate takeaway of the gift.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
If you want an ultimate takeaway of Christmas, then you have to know the resurrection.
That's good. I love it. Okay, bear with me again because we have a wonderful, another person watching.
Praise God. Amen.
Listen, your wife is watching.
Are you kidding?
She knows what to do.
All right.
So, Sister Gardner, when he gets home, I'm going to ask you if you would send him up. So go in his app store, put in a password, load him on Facebook so that we can next week. I can hook him up.
All right. I feel good now that my wife is watching. Amen. Now we hear from George. Now you call George. You tell George it's time for him to plug in. Amen. Then we know that we're coming.
Amen.
Praise God. But that's what we have to look at in conclusive terms. We disconnect this. We celebrate the birth of Jesus, and we drop him after the 25th.
That's so true.
And don't think about him anymore until after next year or the following year, December the 25th.
Mm-hmm.
But all of this has a connection.
It's all connected.
The birth of Jesus is designed for the death of Jesus. Glory to God.
Right.
And the death of Jesus really what brings us life and everlasting life. Amen. Praise God. It ceases to be just a baby born in a manger and there was no room in the inn.
That
feel that. That translates, minister, into a savior.
Wow.
a deliverer, a healer. Amen. All of that culminates here in our time that we're celebrating right now, which is the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ.
What a wonderful gift.
Amen. What a gift. You cannot, it's not two. It's not two persons we're talking about. We're talking about the same person that was born in that manger. It's the same person that now we're celebrating and receiving the reason in this part of our season is the connectivity. Amen. And that's how we, and you know what? That's how we can manage our salvation. By knowing that all of this has a meaning.
Yes.
Amen. That Christmas has a meaning.
Hallelujah.
The resurrection has a meaning. The death has a meaning. All of it is coming. Because if there's no death, there's no resurrection. If he had not died, everything else would be moot. Even the birth.
Wow.
If Jesus hadn't died, then the birth wouldn't matter.
So true.
You know, so the thanks be to God,
amen,
that we have the resurrection, the birth, the death, the resurrection, amen,
and the ascension.
And don't forget the coming back.
Oh, my God.
That's the ultimate of this all, that he's coming back.
We have full circle.
That one day you can look up and say, truly come, Lord Jesus. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. God is a great God.
Yes, you are.
But again, this is Pastor Robert Gardner with Minister Rosetta Archer, and we are live in the studios of WHPR TV 33, and you can get go onto your
Facebook.
Amen.
Amen. To catch us on Facebook Live, just go to RJ Watkins and WHPR, and you'll be able to plug right in.
Right in there.
Amen.
If you have any comments or questions, let's get them, and we will talk about it.
Amen.
Amen. Before I get into, again, the takeaway that I want you to have as we move into this season, amen, is that God will move the stone. Amen. Now, even though it speaks future, but it's yet present tense. Amen. As I said, when the word of God is spoken, the activity of that word begins to operate in our lives. When we pray healing, amen. When you pray deliverance, you are not praying in a possibility sense. You're praying because knowing.
Amen.
I know what I'm praying.
Yes,
I know what I'm speaking is God for you.
Yes.
So therefore, I won't, even though that we say God will move the stone, I want you to look at it in the now.
Yes.
I want you to see it in the now.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God is doing this now.
Right now.
That frustration that you have, that anxiety that you have, amen, that scare that you have, a fear that you have of the things that you have to do, and there's some possibility that it may not work like you want it to work, I want you to let that go. And know that when you get there, amen. You're going to read this word in just a minute. When you get there, so this means that you got to move. And I think in terms of when you get there, I think about Jehoshaphat.
Yes.
How Jehoshaphat came up against the enemies that came up against him and Israel. And God had spoken the word.
Yes.
This battle is not yours. You have not to fight it.
Yes.
But what did they have to do? Yet had they had to get up early in the morning and go down to the core. They needed to see their victory. You need to go so you can see your victory. You need to experience what God has already done. Get rid of the fear. Get rid of the fright. Amen. And get ready to experience what God has already done. When we talk about the death, when we talk about the resurrection, when we talk about Easter Sunday morning, amen. Praise God. You know, we're talking about getting ready to expose yourself to what's already done.
Amen. doing it. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Already done.
Already done. Praise God. So good. Amen. So we're going to read the scripture in just a minute. Amen. But what I want you to pray. I feel the anointing of prayer.
Thank you, Jesus.
And what prayer does, as it did for Jesus.
Yes.
Jesus prayed until he developed an offense. He was able to deal with. He was not in defensive mode.
Mm.
But he prayed.
Hallelujah.
He released himself into the hands of the Father.
Hallelujah.
He was able to go to the cross.
Hallelujah.
He was able to handle that Gethsemane experience.
Yes.
And you hear me say that in order to become spiritual, you're going to have to handle that flesh. You don't jump from carnal to spiritual.
Yes.
You have to go through carnal to get to spiritual. Oh, I like your fellas. Amen. And see, that's why a lot of time people have so many struggles in their life. They think, okay, I came to church and gave my life to Christ, and Lord, my life is worse. All you're doing now is getting rid of the carnality that had been in your life and have held you down, as did Jesus. When Jesus went through that Garden of Gethsemane, he was getting rid of all of those things that had challenged him in order to get to where he was.
Yes,
and when he got to the place and began to release his spirit into the hand of the Father, that's why he could look at the disciples and say, y'all sleep on. Amen.
Amen.
This is all about the Father and me. It's all about us, man. It's not about you. I wanted you all to pray, and hopefully that you'll be spent. But since you was tired and fatigued and all of that, and you decided to go to sleep, then sleep on.
Sleep on.
Amen. Praise God. Because I have been so empowered. Amen. So that's what prayer does.
It empowers us.
Amen. I am so empowered by prayer and praying that whatever is before me, I know that I can handle it now. Because I have connected with a higher source than my own. And that's what Jesus did. Jesus, I mean, he had to go through this three times, and you know, and then finally recognize that, hey, you know, not my will,
but you're
not what I am thinking that I ought to do and not do, but it's what your will is for me to do. And that's where we deal that offense. Amen. And we're not being challenged any longer by the devil.
That's good.
But you know, I want you to pray. Amen. But I just feel that there ought to be a time in your spiritual life with the empowerment of the Holy Spirit operating in your life that the devil is no longer a challenge to you.
Jesus, that's good. Say that again. Say that again.
With the Holy Spirit, giving the Holy Spirit latitude to work in your life, there ought to be a time in your spiritual walk with God that the enemy is no longer a challenge to you. I live in victory. I walk in victory. I talk in victory. Amen. Praise God. So he's no longer a challenge with me. And I'm tired of folks throwing, and I say it sometime too, and probably going to say it before I go up there today, probably say it Sunday morning. But I'm learning to say it with some, not so much definitiveness and actuality. That's John 10:10.
Yes.
The devil, the enemy, comes to kill, steal, and destroy.
Yes.
Quit throwing that at Christians. Quit throwing that at people.
Well,
amen. Why are you building a fear on something that cannot do what he came to do? Because Colossians tells us that he has the power that he had has been taken away. And God has triumphed
him. Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Made a spectacle of him.
Amen.
So what he came to do, yes, what he came.
What he came.
Past
him. Yes.
Amen. What he came to do, amen, he can no longer do.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
So we can bypass that for now. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. Because the alert is not what the devil came to do. It's what Jesus came to do.
That's the alert.
That's the alert. Alert people alerting me on the devil activity, what the devil can do, but alert me on what God has already done through Jesus Christ.
He said, but I can't.
Okay, but that we don't have to.
Your face. We turn from our evil ways, oh God, and we're going to heal from heaven, oh God, and you're going to heal the land in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
God, we lift
yes,
that
yes.
trust to you in the name of
hallelujah,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We pray for your wisdom, oh God. We pray laborers unto him, oh God, mentors unto him that will bring him the word of God in a way that he can receive it, understand it, and apply it in the name of Jesus, oh God. And we thank you, we praise you that President Trump, the entire cabinet of God, the
Senate
of the House, in the
yes,
name of Jesus,
yes.
oh God, they will enact laws and they will make decisions based on the blessings for the people
yes,
in the name
yes,
of Jesus,
yes,
God. We
yes.
thank you and we do praise you, oh God, that we're not moved to the left or to the right. We know that, oh God, you sit high and look low in the name of Jesus. And your word says that the heart of the king is in your hand
yes,
and you're turning
yes,
and shifting
yes,
in the name of Jesus,
yes,
oh God. And as we continue to do our part, oh God, as we pray and intercede for the president in the name of Jesus, all shall be well in the name of
yes,
Jesus and in the land. Father, we
yes,
thank you.
Sir.
We
yes,
bind up every negative word against him in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood over him, over his house in the name of Jesus, over this nation and in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood, oh God, and we thank you
thank
that
you.
You're raising up peacemakers
thank
in the name of
you.
Jesus.
Thank
you're raising
you.
Up peacemakers in every neighborhood, oh God,
hallelujah.
In every home in the name of Jesus, in every city, oh God, in every state, oh God,
yes,
in our entire
yes,
nation,
yes,
oh God,
yes.
and across the globe. You are raising up peacemakers
thank
in the name
Jesus.
Of Jesus, oh God, and I thank you, oh God, for all those that you've called to be peacemakers. We take hold of the mantle in the name of Jesus, and we go forth in it in
yes,
power
yes,
and
yes, yes,
by
yes,
your spirit.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus, oh God, we thank you.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
We go back to work under the blood, glory to God. We go back to school under the blood in the name of Jesus. We leave our homes under the blood
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, oh God. We give you glory, honor, and praise, Father. We thank you for what you're yet doing, what you're yet speaking to us. We have ears to hear what your spirit was saying to us. And we ask that you bless every viewer, every listener, as only you can, oh God. And we thank you that we declare that today is a day of peace.
Hallelujah.
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 Lord, in Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Lord,
praise God.
God. Hallelujah.
It is so.
It is so.
It is so. It is so. It is so. And so it is.
Glory.
Well, my sisters, brother, this is Pastor Gardner from Ministry with an Arch, and we're just happy to be here. We're excited.
Yes,
I'm excited about it. The Lord is
real.
Lord,
glory
God.
To God. We are alert.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And
thank
we
you,
thank
Jesus.
God for what this season right here commences
yes.
with
Hallelujah.
And what it brings
yes.
to the life of the believer.
Amen.
Again, we are live here in the studios of WHBR TV 33. And again, we're Facebook Live. You're on Facebook.
Yes, we are.
Amen.
We got more viewers. We get likes.
Amen.
And everybody, I'm trying
all
not
right.
to look at it too much. Amen.
Amen. So if you would like, if you have a comment, you can send that. Or you would like to call us.
Yeah,
amen.
Absolutely.
Call us if you would like to. The numbers that are on your screen there, or you're picking them up on Facebook.
868-4336,
868-0351, or 868-0342. And 313 area. Well, listen, I want to just, you know, I want to be focused. Our time seems to just go.
This
is the fastest hour in show business. I'm telling you,
amen.
And then when we sit down, it's time
yes.
to get up. Amen. But I want you to look at, if you would read for me, that's Mark, the 16th chapter. Verses 1 through 4. We're going to see if we can get that in because I want you to get this takeaway. What's before you, amen, and the circumstances, Psalms 138 says, he will perfect that which concerns thee.
Yes, he will.
Now, I think that, I believe that during this time and what has already occurred and what is occurring now
Hallelujah.
Is your perfection.
Yes.
He brings those things to naught. He's challenged every disease, every affliction. He's challenged every ruler, and he has come through victorious
yes.
for you.
Amen.
Everything
Jesus.
That he did,
yes.
he did it for you and I.
Praise God.
So I want you right now to, as you were saying in your prayer, it's been raised. The alert level
yes.
has been raised.
We're high alert.
And we're on high alert. And that is because of
yes.
what Jesus
right.
has already done.
Uh-huh.
Amen. So God will move stones from your life.
Amen.
Amen. Now, I want you to listen to this, and this is your takeaway today. Amen. Amen. Yes.
In verse 1, it says, and when the Sabbath was passed,
yes,
Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome had brought sweet spices that they might come and anoint him.
Mm-hmm.
And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun.
Yes.
And they said among themselves, who shall?
Now watch this. Go ahead and say, who?
Who shall roll us away the stone?
Unnecessary anxiety. Unnecessary frustration.
Mm.
Amen. What usually happens to us before we get there? On our way to the courthouse, on our way to the hospital, on our way to the loan office, on our way to the gas bill, I pay the gas bill, and you don't have all the money. And not knowing that the person that you were talking to before had called in sick, and God has put someone else there to look at your situation in a different way. Unnecessary, oh my God. Hallelujah.
That's good.
Unnecessary anxiety.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You've seen something on an x-ray. Now you're going back to get it analyzed. And you go back and the doctor says, well, we've got to repeat this.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Something is not right. And then they find out, I'm sorry.
Yes.
There was a button in your pocket.
Right.
You know, and you have you had a sleepless night.
Mm-hmm.
And you just couldn't rest.
Right.
And you went in with the unnecessary anxiety.
That's good.
Unnecessary frustration. Unnecessary, a worry.
Yes.
Jesus takes the worry
yes.
out of our lives.
That's so good.
Amen.
Amen.
So here these women, they were patriotic. They was religious. They was doing what they normally do.
That's so true. Yes.
But they didn't realize
Jesus.
That this was not a normal time.
Hallelujah.
Like I said before,
yes,
you cannot face it being normal.
Wow.
Amen. Amen. You cannot make it through this year being normal.
Amen.
So the normal thing what they did, they went and got this pot, went and bought some more spices and got their bags and everything full, getting ready to go there. I commend them for the activities that they were doing. But they didn't get it. Amen. They didn't get it. Praise God. Amen. So, but one thing about it, that when you are operating from a pure heart,
yes.
God will change your faith level.
Wow.
Amen. Praise God. He will not allow you to continue to walk in darkness.
So good.
He will change your faith level so that you can catch hold to the righteousness of God and be able to walk, amen, by faith and not by sight. So when they get there, they're on their way to the Lord, that's a heavy stone. You got heavy burdens in your life.
Yes.
Heavy trouble. It's a heavy stone. You cannot do it by yourself.
Amen.
You concluded that. You know that.
That's right.
What you're faced with, the destruction of the enemy,
Amen.
What he is attacking you with,
Hallelujah.
And all of those things, they're just too much for you.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot handle it.
Yes.
Amen. And
Amen.
That's what these women was confronted with.
Yeah.
Amen. They said, look, it's a heavy stone.
Yes. Amen.
Who's going to roll it?
Who?
Now, that who is relative in the sense. She looked around with her, and who was with her?
We got Mary, the mother of Jesus, and Salome.
Amen.
Amen.
Which one of us going to roll it?
We can't roll the stone away.
Amen.
It's too heavy for us.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Sometimes we walk through life like that.
Jesus.
Don't get mad with your friend.
Mm.
Don't get angry with your relative. They can't do it.
Amen. Amen.
Those person that's close around you many times cannot do what you need to be done.
That's good.
So sometimes it's better for them to shut their mouths. It's better for them not to intervene. Don't get upset.
Amen.
Amen. They said who?
Who?
They look around them. We can't do
it. We can't do it.
I don't know who's going to do this. But
Hallelujah.
We're going anyway.
Amen. Going to God.
That's the key right
Amen.
There. We're not going to stop.
Amen.
We're not going to allow the possibility of something being in our way to stop us.
We're not going to allow the possibility of an obstacle.
Now you're talking. Amen.
To keep us from pursuing what we know God is us to do.
Oh, my God.
What he's called us to have. Walking in what he's called us to walk in.
Amen.
We're not going to let an obstacle stop us from getting to that expected end.
Amen.
Glory to God.
How many times, minister, on that better court, how many times I know people who stop short of their destiny or vision, stop short of their purpose because of what their anticipation was. I know I ain't gonna get the money. I know they're not letting me have the money. Oh, no.
That's true.
Amen. Amen. And they stop.
That's so true.
Amen.
So true.
People give up.
Yes.
You go to the doctor, then what? Then the reality is what the doctor said. You come home and you're ready to die. Amen. Forgetting that God is a healer, that's fine. He was wounded for our transgressions.
That's what
he
elected.
Amen. The chastisement of his body, and by his stripes, you are healed. Okay, now how many people died? I'm going to keep the faith that the next one, excuse me, ain't me.
Amen.
Amen. I don't care how many people have failed. The next one is not me.
Not me. Glory to God.
I'm going to walk in the belief that the stone has been rolled away.
Glory to
God. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Right there.
You say so. So whatever has gone on before you, you have to declare in your life that the next one is not me.
It's not me.
That next defeat is not mine.
Not mine. Glory to God.
Amen. That next disappointment is not mine. That next frustration is not mine. Amen. It's not coming in.
It's not coming in.
The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus.
Amen. We shut every door.
Amen.
No obstacle. Glory to God.
Amen. So here they are.
Ooh,
it was heavy. All right, we don't.
Amen. And they said among themselves,
yes.
Who shall roll us away the stone from the door of the sepulchre?
Amen. There is a power. Yes, there is a power. That's not intimidated. Now, this reconfirms what I said earlier. When the word of God is spoken, the activity of God begins to work right there.
That's good.
God had already done what these women wanted and needed to be done.
Amen.
It didn't start on the day that they got there. But God knew that these women was coming the next morning.
Yes, he did.
I got to get Jesus up early and get him out of here. Amen. Praise God. To eliminate their struggle.
Praise
God. God will eliminate your struggles. He will eliminate your pain because he knows what you came to do and what you have to do in your life. Praise God. Amen. So he said what?
Amen. In verse 4.
Yes.
And when they, Jesus.
That's my blessing.
See, the provision, what can we just say? The provision was already made.
Amen. Hallelujah.
They're reasoning among themselves, who's going to roll away realizing and understanding that God had already done it.
Yes.
What they needed done was already done. The provision for what they were going to do had already been there.
Yes.
And the stone was already rolled away.
They could have failed.
Worrying about it.
They could, blood pressure went up.
My God.
Your diabetes off track. You know, worrying about.
My Lord.
So what God is trying to say to us today, that I've settled all of this for you through my death, burial, and resurrection. I have removed the stone. And this is what I like about this word. Amen. Praise God. And when you were talking there, I was thinking about the lepers that was at the gate. If we stay here, we know what's going to happen.
We already know what's going to happen if we stay.
But by chance, when we go over there to the gate, somebody over there may have compassion. Lo and behold, they went over there with anybody there. And they just had their feet. They sat down and they didn't have to pack up and leave the water. Those lepers went through that tent. They sat down and they ate.
They did.
They filled themselves with the goodness of God.
Hallelujah.
And that's what God wants to do to you, my sisters and brothers, in this season.
Amen.
He wants to fill your life with his goodness. Hallelujah. He is want to fill your life with his blessing.
Hallelujah.
Right today, right now, God is initiating the ultimate miracle for your life.
Amen. That's God.
The ultimate miracle. for your life.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's being reproduced right now through the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise God. And that word says what?
Hallelujah. And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled
to the first part of their prayer.
And
when they got there.
Amen. And when they looked, they saw.
That's it. What's the beginning of it? Is that the beginning of it?
Yes. Let's go to three. And they said among themselves,
yes.
Who shall roll us away the stone from the door of the sepulchre?
Yes.
And when they looked. They saw.
When they got there, they saw.
Hallelujah.
What did they say?
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
They saw that the stone was rolled away.
Rolled away.
Hallelujah.
Now, sisters and brothers, this is your takeaway.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The stone, has already
Hallelujah.
Been rolled away.
Yes, glory
to God. Pastor, God, you don't know what I'm going through.
Oh, that's good.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
Amen. It's heavy.
Yes.
It's been a struggle. It's been something that you have been dealing with over a period of time.
My God.
I want you to catch hold of this word by faith.
Glory to God.
And walk in it.
Hallelujah. Glory
that
to
during
God.
This season,
yes.
That whatever is going on in my life,
whatever it is,
or has been there for a long period of time,
Amen.
It doesn't matter.
Hallelujah.
I want you to walk in faith today to believe that the stone has already been. And notice when they look.
Yes. Glory to God.
They what?
Saw. Glory to God. Hallelujah.
When they
Jesus. Hallelujah.
They saw.
Hallelujah.
That the very thing that they had been worrying about.
The deliverance had already come.
Had come. What does next verse say?
Hallelujah. And let me just finish that. Because you were just saying, it doesn't matter what it is. You might, like you said, you don't know my situation.
Right.
You don't know
right.
what it is. Hallelujah. It says, for the stone was very great.
For the stone was very
great. It was very great.
That's a matter.
It was very great.
So look at the magnitude.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Look at what the challenge has been.
Yes.
Amen. God is a healer. He is a deliverer.
Yes, he is
your Savior.
Ooh,
it doesn't matter. That family member that you've been praying for, that family member that you believe in God, continue to do it.
Amen.
Because it's not you that have to save them.
Yes.
It's not you that have to deliver
That's
them.
Good.
But it's God who has already done that.
Thank you, Jesus.
So you can invite anyone to church.
Amen.
Don't try to save them. Don't get mad because they reject you. Don't get mad Amen. Because they don't come. Your job is to continue to pray.
Yes.
And watch the power of
Amen.
God work in your life.
Amen.
A stone has already been rolled away. Listen, my sister and brothers,
oh,
our time
goodness.
Is out again. Amen. But I'm inviting you to come and worship with us this week. On Friday at 12 noon, we will be in service at 7107 Rivard Avenue. And then on that Friday night in a great anointing service, I want you to come and be anointed and receive this blessed oil that God, amen, has put together for us to be anointed with. I want you to come in the service. And we are blessing families.
Amen.
I'm believing God for family, the resurrection of family.
Yes.
The devil trying to destroy families.
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
Keep families out of the blessings of God and keeping them at odds with. I want you to join us on Friday night here at the Word of Truth at 7 p.m. Again on Sunday morning in our main worship service at 10:45 a.m. I'm not having Sunday morning, early morning sunrise service. I'm having sunrise prayer service. So at 7 a.m., I'm going to be in prayer here at the Word of Truth, and we're going to pray, amen, and believe God. And then we're going in our worship service at 10:45 a.m.
Amen.
I want you to come and join us at 7107 Rivard Avenue in Warren, Michigan. Our phone number is on the screen, 586-754-9673. My sisters and brothers, amen. And minister, say something to the people as we get ready to move us.
Amen.
I do want them, listen, Sunless Skies. I mean, this is a good time. We give gifts. Amen. Don't go buy Easter Lily. Don't go buy a rabbit with some candy in his mouth. Get this book and bless, amen, someone in a tangible, longevity way. Get this book amen, sunless skies by Minister Rosetta Archer, it will certainly be a blessing to you. And she's going to tell you how you can get in touch with her, her ministry, if you want to come and minister to you, your family, your friends, or your church, amen, your group, and how she can get this book. Amen. Take your time and tell us. Amen. Sunless skies. Amen.
Amen. So you can get the book on Amazon.com.
Yes.
So go to my website, which is sunlessskies.com. Mm-hmm. If you'd like to reach me, one of the easiest ways, you may email me at rosetta.archer@gmail.com. If you'd like to give us a call, you can call us at 346-3605. And if that's too fast for you, you can always call the front desk at the station and they can give you my information.
248-346-3605. That's 248-346-3605.
Yes, sir.
Listen. You will be blessed, super blessed, by having her to come and share in your ministry group, women. She specializes in relationship. Let's get it together. Sunless Skies by Minister Rosetta Archer. Listen, until we meet again, on next Tuesday, live in the studios of WHPR-TV 33, we want you to remember the takeaway today. It's a high alert.
It's a high alert.
That stone is rolled away. Keep looking unto Jesus himself and finish up your faith. And remember that the truth will make you free.